This is another recipe, but I don't have no measurements for. We always made them just out of your head. And this is the coconut. I husk the coconut and chip it up and grate it. And then I put it in the pot and boil it with the brown sugar and some spices. And after that, I have the pumpkin on. You peel this and pour it. And when it's cooked, you crush it up. And it will look like this. And when it's crushed up. And then you put it in your pan here. It's the crushed pumpkin. Put this in the pan. And you add some spice to it. And your corn starch. You cannot make a cake without corn starch because it's too, it doesn't, the pumpkin don't have any starch.
What about flour, Miss Lucy?
Well, I guess you could use flour, but I always use corn starch for some reason. So you have to mix these all up until you get a paste. And you put butter into your coconut milk too. You have to have butter into your coconut milk. So I have it into a paste now, and then I add my boiled coconut milk.
And your special spices, right?
Yes. My coconut milk. And you keep mixing it up until it's all into without any lumps into it. Mix it until there's no lumps left into it. Then you can pour. You see, this has some lumps. You can add a little bit of vanilla flavoring. As, of course, as I say, I don't measure mine. I just do it as I go. Recipe in my head. And not everybody. Some people cannot do things without having a recipe, but I just go along and do mine as I was taught in olden days. So now, this now is almost ready. You have your pan greased, your oven ready, and pour in your pans. And you bake it at 350 for 3.5 to 4 hours. You know, it depends on the size of the cake. You know, the smaller ones won't take, but when you make the big ones, like when I brought there, 4 hours. So you have to, you have to mix it. This is a little bit thin. You gotta have it. That's another thing. Judgment. Judgment. And this is almost ready now on the side of getting ready for a pan. Yeah, it's one bit thinner than that, not much, but a little bit. See? Yeah, one bit thinner than that, and then it's ready to go in the oven. So then and you can keep topping it sometimes, but sometimes I don't top it because pumpkin, a thing I found, don't get dry. You know, the cassava cakes, they'll get dry if they don't have enough butter into them or coconut, but pumpkin doesn't get dry. So you have to top cassava cakes, but not pumpkin. You don't have to top that. So that's about another half a cup of water if you find that. And it'll be ready to go in the oven and bake. So that's just how I do mine. And this is that's a sample of what I brought.
Thank you, Ms. Lucy.